The following opinions are solely those of BoatTEST.com and its test captain.
Hi, Captain Steve for BoatTEST.com, and today we're going to be taking a look at a boat from Sea Ray that is the largest boat in Sea Ray's sport cruiser line, the Sundancer 350 Coupe. This boat has dual-purpose design flexibility for day boating and overnight cruising, plus options that allow the boat to be personalized. The difference between the Sundancer 350 and the Sundancer 350 Coupe is that the Coupe version has a fully protected helm with solid windshield and side windows that connect to the hardtop. Let's start our performance evaluation and features inspection with the test numbers. The Sea Ray 350 Coupe has a length overall of 37 feet 6 inches, a beam of 11 feet 4 inches, and carries a fuel capacity of 214 gallons. With an empty weight of 18,792 pounds, 60% fuel, and 3 people on board, we had an estimated test weight of 20,039 pounds. With the optional upgrade to twin 380 horsepower Mercury 8.2 liter MAG ECTC core engines with Bravo 3X drives, we reached our top speed of 36.8 miles per hour at 4750 RPM. Best cruise came in at 4000 RPM and 31 miles per hour. It was at that speed that the 40.5 gallon per hour fuel burn translated into 0.8 miles per gallon and a range of 147 statute miles, all while still holding back a 10% reserve of the boat's 214 gallon total fuel capacity. We had an average time to plane of 6.8 seconds, accelerated to 20 miles per hour in 11.9, and 30 in 21.7 seconds. We had mild conditions on test day, so little chance to comment on how she handles chop, but crossing wakes showed how her bow presents a dry ride by dispersing spray. I did put the boat through its paces for turn angles, etc., and at speed she does ride with the bow up somewhat and has a high center of gravity. Maneuvering around the dock, the 350 Coupe fitted with optional bow thruster and Axis propulsion system joystick was spot on. For those stepping up to a bigger boat like this and are concerned about maneuvering, this package should eliminate those concerns. Save money by opting only for the bow thruster, which is all that's needed after a little practice. At the forward end of the coupe enclosure is the helm station. Again, one of the features of the 350 Coupe is that the helm is in an enclosed space with a solid windshield and side windows under the hardtop, something that's quite welcome when the weather kicks up or when the optional salon air conditioning heater is wanted. The helm seat itself is a double-wide bench with a flip-up bolster if you choose to stand while driving. It also swivels around when the boat is at rest so two more can join in the cockpit conversation. The magnetic compass is centered on the instrument pod, but not lined up with the wheel. There are cup holders over the 9-inch touchscreen chart plotter to the left, which will make a good place to hold smartphones, keys, and a handheld VHF. There are small craft multi-gauges to the right. A long single row of electrical rockers are lighted when activated and are centralized within easy view and reach. I like that the horn button stands out in red. The Axis propulsion system joystick and bow thruster controls are to the right-hand side. The single-piece windshield with pantograph wipers provide good visibility for the helmsman. A chaise lounge seat is to port. It can be used both lying down and sitting up facing the captain. Vent side windows are on either side of the forward area. The flexibility of this boat begins right here at the swim platform with a built-in electric grill, stainless steel sink, and cover to create a food prep counter. Two handy pull-out drawers are underneath. The 350 Coupe can be ordered with an extended swim platform with teak decking or even one that lowers into the water. Our test boat had the optional extended platform
and the electrically actuated swim step underneath.
To port, hatch reveals shore power cables and other connections. The engine room under the aft deck is accessed by means of an electrically actuated lift. Here we find the twin Mercury 8.2 liter big block engines, which are the largest engines available for this boat. The oil dipsticks are on the starboard side of each engine. The oil filters have their own drip trays, and engine coolant reservoirs are at the front of the engines. To the right is a diagram of the serpentine belt routing. Port and starboard saddle aluminum fuel tanks have a capacity of 214 gallons total. The generator is forward of the engines on the center line. The batteries have rubber protectors on their terminals. Note that the generator bronze raw water pickup is bonded with the green wire and is double hose clamped. And exhaust risers and hoses are double clamped as required by ABYC standards. Topside, we enter the cockpit from the swim platform via a plexi and stainless steel gate on the starboard side. The first things we noticed were the recessed mooring cleat for cross-tying the stern, a rod holder, a cleat for side mooring, a courtesy light, and the three fiberglass steps up to the side decks. Just to the left is an L-shaped settee that surrounds a standard fiberglass table or, this optional solid wood version, both on a high-low pedestal, all with dedicated storage under the engine hatch. There's another settee to starboard of the table with a cockpit fridge below the seat. Over that starboard settee is an optional flat-screen TV and a swivel mount. Overhead, our boat has a powered sunroof that measured 5 feet wide by 2 feet 8 inches fore and aft. It has a positive close to keep out the water, and note the blue courtesy lighting. The cockpit melds with the helm area to the extent that the helm seat swivels to add seating to the cockpit. The aft edge of the hardtop even has an optional motorized retractable sure shade awning to shade the cockpit table on sunny days. Side decks leading to the bow are 6 inches wide. The outboard safety rail and the handrail on the coach roof offer good support going forward. The sun pad has adjustable backrests which create two chaise lounges, and in the middle is a seat for sunning. Just forward of the sun pad is the recessed anchor station. The windlass has a cover on a gas shock to protect it when not in use. The anchor is a galvanized plow and the foot pedal controls are just to the side. I always like to see a cleat to take the standing load off the windlass, and this boat has one. There is access to the anchor locker, but I would like to see a far larger opening. Now let's take a look down below. The companionway below has 4 wooden steps with non-skid inserts. There's 6 feet 4 inches of headroom. Owners have a choice of cherry or pecan wood finish and a wood sole. The galley is immediately to starboard with a microwave, induction cooktop, solid surface counters, and a fridge below. Side windows in the cabin do not open, but there's an option to add opening ports, such as the one in the galley. Forward into port is an L-shaped settee surrounding a removable dining table. Under the forward seat is a woofer and storage. To port is a love seat, and behind it is the electrical panel. The lounger slides out for conversion into bunks for additional sleeping accommodations. There's a built-in privacy curtain for these occasions. Forward of the settees is the master with the berth angled for easy access. At the entrance, there are a few steps up where the headroom is still adequate over the berth. There are overhead storage lockers around the berth and a hatch for natural light and ventilation. A hanging locker to port separates the master berth from the port settee. Just after that settee is a 32-inch flat-screen TV. The head compartment is to port of the accommodations ladder. It's a vacuum-flush head with a separate shower stall behind a glass door. In addition to the power vent, there's an opening port light for ventilation and a hull side window for natural light. Vessel sink and solid surface countertop complete the space. The standard cabin layout has a separate guest mid-cabin here behind the accommodations ladder with a lockable entry door to port next to the head. There is a small settee to port with a hanging locker and storage lockers above and below the settee, and 6 foot 4 inch long twin bunks run athwartships. The bunks have an insert to combine the two into a double berth. There's also an optional cabin layout where the twin berths are replaced by an L-shaped seat that converts to a sleeper. Opening ports on both sides of the cabin let in light and fresh air. All told, the Sea Ray 350 Coupe could sleep 6. The Sea Ray 350 Coupe is a cruiser that can be used as a day boat or overnight cruising and keeps guests warm and dry in the shoulder season, cool and dry in the summer. And her focus is certainly on entertainment. That's my full inspection and performance evaluation of the Sundancer 350 Coupe from Sea Ray. For BoatTEST.com, I'm Captain Steve. We'll see you on the water.